Today, I'll be showing you how to paint a night scene in Photoshop. Hello YouTube, welcome to my channel. If you are new here, I create videos on my art and I tell you my tips and tricks as a professional artist. If that's something you're interested in, be sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell. Following last week's video where I explained how I drew for 100 days to improve my comic art skills. So in this video, I'll be explaining my process of how I created this. To get things started, I always start with pencil and paper. And once I'm done with that, I take it to Photoshop for inking. I recently made a video about how I create clean line art. If you'd like to check that video, I'll link it up above and in the description below. About a couple of weeks back, I created my character's expression chart, which looks something like this. So it was pretty easy for me to just take one of the expressions from that page and just apply it to this. It saved me a bunch of time, and I'm pretty sure I'll be using this expression chart a bunch of times in the future. This is probably the reason why animation studios first begin their process of creating characters with an expression chart and all the necessary stuff. First, I start the line work for the male character. And as you can see, I'm not trying to draw too many folds in the clothing. Drawing folds in the clothing is always much more effective using colors and shadows. So I'll be doing that later. So once I'm done with the line art of the male character, I move on to the female character. Once you have a process of creating line art and you have a good enough practice of it, eventually you get much better at it and much faster. So if that's something you're struggling in, I keep practicing. I was pretty bad at it too. It took me a while, but I think I'm pretty good now, if I say so myself. Once I'm done with the line art, it's time for coloring. Even though it's a night scene, I always begin coloring just as I would do in a morning scene. Color block it with flat colors and with the colors that are originally on the clothing. No matter if it is night or day, the color of your clothes doesn't change. It's just the environment lighting that changes. So that's what we'll be doing with this artwork. So to give it a night effect, what I like to do is add a color lookup on top of the flat colors. How it looks is, on the right hand side here you can see the adjustment section. Click on the adjustments and select color lookup. Usually for night scene, what I'd like to do is use the moonlight color lookup. So once you add this, it gives a night effect, and from here the fun part begins. Since my character is carrying a lantern, so the light will be directly falling on him. To do that, it's pretty simple. All you need to do is click on the mask section of the color lookup, select your brush tool and set it to black. And once you do that, if you start painting on top of the adjustment layer, it deletes the section that you don't want the night light to be, or the night effect, which we did through selecting the moonlight color lookup. So from here, it's just trial and error of where you think the light would hit on the face and the clothing. And by doing this, I was pretty happy with how it came out on the clothing, but on the face, I feel like there is not enough focus. So what I did was, like I mentioned before, it's good for you to experiment with light and shadows. So if you don't like something, keep doing it again and again till you're satisfied with it. Like you can see here, since I'm unhappy about the light effect on the face, and I don't see enough focus on him, I try to change how the light hits on his face and just try and experiment with it. So after a couple of passes, I found what works for the scene and what looks good. Once I'm done with the male character, the next is adding light and shadows for the female character. Since she's standing behind, I'm not gonna give as much light intensity as I did for the male character. So I'm gonna give a very mild light effect just so we have enough focus on her. Again, it's just adding and deleting light effects over and over again. So once I'm happy with that, the next part is adding some thick black lines in my line art. What this does is, this gives an extra depth that I need, such as you can see here underneath the clothing, underneath the hair, adding adding thick black lines like this gives a sense of depth to all the things we have. So now we have a color set, lighting set. One effect that I found to be very effective is adding a rim light to a night scene. Rim light is nothing but, in this scene as an example, since you are standing outside, the rim light would be the moonlight. So I'm just adding a bit of moonlight effects hitting their head and the side of the body. So this gives an added depth and a pop to our characters. So now the light effects on our characters is done. To finish this off, we need a night background. I kept things pretty simple and kept the background pretty monotone and used different shades of blue for the background. To get things started, I started with the ground where the characters are standing and the light that would hit the ground from the lamp, of some foreground elements so that this gives a focus on the main characters. And once we are done with the foreground elements, it's just layers of shades of blue over and over again. Since this is a forest scene, I'm adding a bunch of trees. I begin by adding a gradient background for the sky, and on top of it I add the branch and the leaves, and after every depth layer I add a mist layer. Adding this gives a sense of depth and it feels a lot more cinematic. And just as I did for the first layer, add branches, leaves and our mist layer. So I keep doing this a bunch of times. The more forward it comes, the darker it becomes, and I add more trees, more mist. By adding the mist, it gives a focus on the characters and they don't blend into the background, and it gives a sense of depth and gives a cinematic look to it. And since we were camping, I added a tent, and I feel this looks pretty good. Now as you can see in the bottom, it looks pretty blank and it feels incomplete. So what I'll do is add some grass texture to it so that it feels like our characters are grounded. And now our scene is complete. Now the top section is pretty empty. After we add our text, there we have it. We have a finished cover design just the way we want it. Couple of characters walking in the forest at night. So this is my process of how I create a night scene. I hope you found this process useful, and I'd like to see you apply this process into your artwork. If you do, be sure to tag me on Instagram. I'll check it out. I'll give you my feedback on it. As always, thank you for watching. See you in the next one.